السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد آج کا سبق سن لیجئے.
Let us listen to the آج کا سبق which is delivered daily by Hazrat Morana Muhammad Yunus the son of Hazrat Morana Muhammad Umar Palanpuri rahmatullahi alayh. Lesson number 930. This is the 10th lesson with regards to the month of Ramadan. In the month of Ramadan, du'as are definitely accepted by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are three categories of people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts their du'as. The one is of a fasting person until he breaks his fast. Number two, the one of a just ruler. And number three, the du'a of an oppressed person. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala takes his du'a on top of the skies, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opens the door of the skies, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts his du'a at times due to his own benefit, perhaps at a later stage, not immediately. This hadith is made mention of in Musnad Ahmad as well as in Tirmidhi Sharif. Hazrat Aisha radiallahu anha would say that in the month of Ramadan, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam's complexion would change. He would increase in dua. He would read more salah. He would ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness. This is a very great, honorable, wonderful, amazing month in the month of Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala even tells those angels that are carrying the arsh of Allah, now you leave this responsibility and you go. Wherever the fasting people are making dua, you go and say ameen to their dua. Yes, sometimes it happens that our du'as are not immediately accepted. People say we made so much of du'a, so much things we done, but how come it's not accepted? I don't think we should think like that. In the future sabaks, inshallah, we will explain. But in the month of Ramadan, as much, as best, as most as you possibly can try to make du'a. These are very, very great months. This entire month is an amazing month Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. And in this year, try and make four statements to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number one, oh Allah, we love you. Number two, oh Allah, we love your Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Number three, oh Allah, we love the Quran. Number four, oh Allah, we love the entire deen. After making these four statements, then make dua, oh Allah, grant us the ability to be able to practice on the entire deen and see how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives us the ability. By not practicing on deen, this is the sign that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is unhappy with us. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be happy with each one of us. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.